was told it was a great honor.
Around this table sit some pretty influential women. Joan of Arc, Amelia Earhart, and Gertrude Stein, to name a few. Or at least they think they are these women.
We just never made friends easily.
In chamber music, the latest production to hit the Stagehouse Theater, courtesy of the Kamloops Players, the lines between reality and delirium are blurred.
That's my riddle!
Chamber music was written in 1962 by Arthur Copit. It is an absurdist comedy. And it's about eight women in a nut house that think that they're famous women from history. And there's also two men who come in and out that are keeping their eye on them. And they have perceived that there's a threat from the men's ward, and they've come together to do something about it. There's so much laughter in this play. It's a very serious subject to them, but they're so absurd.
An interesting challenge for the cast, who have to play off-the-wall versions of some pretty infamous historical figures.
Pearl White was a silent screen actress. She was awesome. In real life, she was really smart and one of the ones that you would see like across the tracks, all tied up and trying to get out.
It's much too dangerous nowadays.
Each one of us had to research our characters, and I did that. I have a German accent throughout this show, and there's some few German words thrown in here and there, so I've researched all the German. I have to sing an aria from Don Giovanni, lip syncing, but to find out what the words in Italian meant, I looked all of that up and looked up the meanings of all of that and why it's in the play and how it fits.
Queen Isabella is a little off the wall, and she's mad, and she's very ticked off at Columbus, who's a total jerk in her mind. And so I have two pages where I rip him to shreds. And the rest of it, I sit and I ignore all these women, because to me, they're just mad. I'm the one with royalty, and I'm the one who knows what's happening.
Well, I don't know much about these things, you understand?
Hours of work have gone into making sure each line and character nuance is perfected. A chore in a play that is chock full of crazy.
There we go. You see? All better.
Character A usually talks to you and you know how to respond, but in this you've got eight women all talking at different times, and little things and laughs and sounds, one single words that are thrown in here and there that you have to get the timing down, right?
You know what, it's refreshing because you really have to stay on top of your game. It's very supportive because you want to support the other person that's speaking and be aware as well where you are at.
I've learned a lot of lines in the past and learned how to do my roles, but this role is, learning my lines is really dependent on everybody else as well, to make sure that the next ones kind of come in. You can't just all of a sudden throw something in when somebody forgets because they don't fit together.
And as with every challenge comes a big reward, a fulfilling collaboration, close friendships, and a great production.
Ask Fred Noonan.
They are all so incredibly giving, and it's been a real collaboration. There really hasn't been much for me to direct yet. And they've all got such great ideas. And so I go home happy and joyful every single time, and they're just wonderful women.
The show runs April 25th, 26th, May 2nd, 3rd, 9th, and 10th at the Stagehouse Theater, and will be representing at this year's Ozone Festival. For more information, visit KamloopsPlayers.com or KamloopsLive.ca. For Shaw TV, I'm Sam Numsen.
In the dark.